everyone, we continue with Ruth. Jesus' answer to any question which make us confused or wondering. We can wonder what Jesus did, but even we know about, we cannot do the same. It's about our ability or our knowledge. We don't encourage us to imitate Jesus, only encourage us to let Jesus live in us and we in him. Thanks God, letting Jesus use us usefully for his grace. Sometimes you find yourself in trouble. You try to rescue yourself by doing something. It helped temporarily, while when we turn to Jesus and ask him for security, then we find it permanent. When you are alone, Satan comes to you and tries to hurt you. But when you are with Jesus, you can defend yourself with help of Holy Spirit. As the same way when Jesus defeated Satan with his Satanist commands, Jesus was strongest than Satan to say him no and reject him. When we are put in temptation, we must be strong with Holy Spirit and Bible and Jesus and tell no. If we are not awakened and fall away from the way, we must try our best to return to the way by asking Jesus for forgiveness. Sometimes worries are sin, for it appears a lot of misjudgments and unreal conclusions. When you become worried, talk with the God, Jesus, Holy Spirit, and the angels, and peace and rest and that take everything positive for you. Why we are here in this world, why we breathe the important oxygen and we breathe out the coal dioxide. The answer is to find and reach God's grace, even we are busy in this world. When we read Bible first time, we step in Christ. When we read it again, it gives us the knowledge to be Christ. When we obey Jesus' words, we are Christ. We are as music instruments, and our understanding is the instrument's song. When we are many to play the same music, we sound different, but together the sound is a very beautiful music. We people have that hidden feelings about the God and his life melody. We start to be in society since we are 1 year. The teachers in the nurse school raise us to prepare us for the society, while the parents' clever belief corrects that child to be succeeded, otherwise the child can be a dull. When people become adult, they get another identity because of the society's rules. But keep always yourself in the arm of Jesus to be successful. What you are good in, then God send the people to you to help them and be more positive. God and Jesus, I cannot help all the needed people, but make us usefully to help a part of them. Amen. There are demons who are Satan's children. They appear in your life and treat you to make you be scared. As soon as they can find the fear, they don't leave you. As long as Jesus freed a lot of people who demons were inside them, you must also powerfully demand the demon to leave those people. Tell to the demon, shut up and leave that person. You must know Bible enough to defeat demons and wrong people. Jesus' words are powerful. Sometimes priests translate the Bible on their understanding. When you find a mistake, then you must correct, but you must know Bible enough. Sometimes demons can be strong enough to don't obey you, even in the name of Jesus. But you can call to Jesus and with his presence, you can push them and leave that person. When Jesus is in you, then you have Jesus' power. Sometimes things are good, better or best, so that it was worth to leave everything for them. Jesus did the same. God's promise for him was the best, and therefore he lived any opportunities in this world for God's promise and grace. In Luca stands about Jesus who healed a lot of people. It was a woman with his sick son and was staying in the queue. When it was her turn, Jesus told everybody that he must go. Not because of that those people didn't deserve Jesus' healing, only because it was other important thing he should do. Jesus told many times that he is here to rescue anybody from any types of harm and that to replace them with God's kingdom. Sometimes you hear warning voices, but not anybody. This is your duty to let everybody hear the warning that they can also save themselves. You must always remind people that Jesus can give us peace and rest, that he helps us in our life. Sometimes we try to do right things, but we find ourselves in difficulties. Therefore, by calling to Jesus, we can be successful. Our duty is that everybody knows about God's grace. Ask God to give you mind, eyes, and understand his purposes to fulfill. Amen. Always you must be awakening to hear Jesus when he gives you a duty. It happens in dream or a meeting or in our world now. The God's communication with us is different. When we have Bible and know about Jesus' life, then we are trying to invite others to Christ, which is a complete life. Knowledge about Jesus lives in us, and we in Jesus, then he guides us. Then trust Jesus. As the same as Jesus invited people by people, then you can do the same. There are many holies in the Bible, so you can use them. God invites us to duties by another people, like to get jobs or educations and so on. Then you can be a leader or worker. Apostles and prophets couldn't help everybody who was poor. Therefore, they invited others to help more poor. Don't doubt to invite people to Jesus. Don't doubt your leadership or actions. The important thing is that don't act alone. Because you have Jesus in you and you are in Jesus, do everything in the name of Jesus. Amen. Have you ever been in a place with a lot of people who one of them is your favorite? You try to find a moment to talk with that person, but you couldn't. In the end of day, you became sorry. It is the same now when you are so busy that you cannot talk with God or Jesus. But God and Jesus has solved this problem. When you are Christ, Jesus lives in you and you in Jesus. Each morning call to Jesus and leave your day in his hand. When Jesus was in this world, any evening he went alone to a place long away from the city and talked with God and angels and other prophets. He worshiped the God there. You haven't all the answers, but with Jesus and Holy Spirit you can only trust. Only tell to the God that you have done yours and that you leave him to make a good result. Amen. Sometimes we meet careless people and we are careful. Try to correct them and learn them how they can be orderly. When we have a meeting with someone who we have respect for, we try to make our room clear and hide things in the shelf that it becomes orderly. Jesus makes us in order to our belief. Jesus rescues us from our sins and corrects us. A lot of selfish people point on other people's careless life that you think that the first person is clear and orderly, while this misjudgment is very bad. And you must stop that person to judge people, and that person is negative. Fasta is a kind of sadness to feel poor people's needs and life. When Jesus was in this world, nobody did fasta because the Savior Jesus was here to help the poor. If we are in Jesus, we have new things. You must find them and use them usefully and help others to do the same. We people are in three groups: successful, them who are dependent on laws, and those who think that the new covenant is hard and stay in the old covenant for having more rules. When we cannot live our proud, we cannot bend us in front of cross and Jesus. Jesus doesn't make us orderly. He makes us new and clean and give us what we need to reach the good God's kingdom. When we have troubles by others, Jesus helps us to clean our path if you ask him humbly. If someone points on your mistake and try to lead you to his judgment, we react that, who is that person? While if that person nicely show the right path, we become happy. Unfortunately, in our times, the youths have left the churches. It can be the church's leadership causing this. The church is a place for forgiveness of sins, but maybe they condemn people. When Pharisees complained Jesus that he did against the Sabbath, Jesus replied that their human laws hinder him to do his heavenly and kind job for people. Jesus does a lot of miracles in Sabbath days in front of Pharisees because he wanted correct people to don't accept all human laws which make their life hard. All negativity hinder you to do kind things. You have heard that do not do things against the laws to be kind to others. While Jesus teaches us to be kind to people, even it is against human laws. But defer this with those who are criminals and do against the human laws and put people in trouble. Sometimes God gives us some instruments for our usage and blessings, but demons appear and forbid those instruments. You find the demons as your enemies. Of course, you are trying to defend them, to defend your instrument in the name of Jesus. Jesus has told us, love your enemies and pray for those who are bad to you, because Jesus will make us kind as he is. Do not let hate appear in you. It is what Satan and his demons will. Kindness is an unconditional action. Grace is that does something with you without return. But action is that does something that you request the return action. With this kind of life, people can see you as God's child. Do not forget that Jesus forgave all his enemies, which made that Jesus raised from the dead. God is nice to everybody, even bad people, because there is hope that they confess their wrong and sins and be forgiven. God always helps us and gives us resources to rescue us from troubles made by demons. When God gives you something, he gives the strength to. Sometimes God gives us a difficult duty, but the reason is to develop our industry. Like in old times, God requested a statue by a stone, but God learned them how they can make instruments to do that job easier. Do with people as the same as you want to be treated. If you want to be loved, then love people. Grace tells that I am kind to you so that I wish your kindness. But action tells I am kind to you if you do something for me. When you obey Jesus, you deserve eternal life and good life. Be kind as like as the God is. Jesus warned that you be abused by others. He defends you because he lives in you and you in him. Sometimes important people spread a lot of lies behind you. It can take time to correct, but the important thing is to defend yourself with your goodness. Demons are divider. Holy Spirit is joiner. Some believers lives in grace, but it is risk that they take distance from the reality in the society. Jesus was the Word. He came with complete grace and righteousness. Then keep yourself in those so that Jesus likes to live in you. Don't judge as like as you don't want be judged. Don't condemn so that you don't want be condemned. Jesus' first coming wasn't as judge, only to save us. In his second coming, he is judge. In the time between first and second coming, he makes us holy, complete, and righteous. We must live in grace and correct the reality in society and invite others to it. Don't be worried to be mistaken. Correct or let Jesus defend you. We are full of grace and righteousness because Jesus is in us. Amen.